Good evening, everyone, and welcome here. My name is Emma Nguyen. I'm a third-year percussion major here at Desautels Faculty of Music, and we are so excited to share this wonderful evening with you guys tonight. First, we would like to acknowledge that the University of Manitoba campuses are located on original lands of the Anishinaabe, Cree, Oji-Cree, Dakota, and Dene peoples, and on the homeland of the Métis Nation. We respect the treaties that were made on these territories, and we acknowledge the harms and mistakes of the past. And we dedicate ourselves to move forward in partnership with the Indigenous communities in a spirit of reconciliation and collaboration. We would ask that right now you take a moment just to silence your devices, and now would you please join me in welcoming the University of Manitoba Concert Band, led by Jackie Dawson, Dr. Jackie Dawson. Thank you.
So excited to be back in full capacity, all members of the ensemble back. This is a much bigger group than you would have seen in the spring, and certainly a much bigger group than you would have seen 2 years ago. So we're super excited. The University of Manitoba Concert Band, we're almost 70 members right now, a range of individuals from all across campus, folks in the community, Desautels Faculty of Music students, as well as many alumni, which is really exciting to see these alumni coming back because they don't want to leave. They just don't get enough. So we're very excited to have you with us this evening. The next piece on the program is actually a commission that this group was part of, but didn't get to be premiered last year due to we were only able to have one concert last year and we didn't have time to program it. This is a consortium commission, meaning a number of organizations, other universities across North America, and we are the Canadian premiere of this piece. Tom DeVoren is a composer originally from Wales, from the UK, a very dear, close friend of mine. We were doctoral colleagues together at the University of Kansas, and he wrote this piece just a year ago. It's in no better place to premiere it than in Winnipeg. It's basically a musical homage to the prairies. We have the prairie, we have a storm, and we have the sunset. And it is reminiscent of those kind of sights, sounds, and images, but also there's musical motif that threads the entire work. The most important tune you're going to hear as a unifying theme is Home on the Range, and then there's also a snippet in there of Sunflower Song that was made famous by Frank Sinatra. So we hope you enjoy Tom DeVoren's, the world premiere of a Midwestern, sorry, Canadian premiere of a Midwestern suite.
Thank you.
good time to embarrass somebody. Before I introduce our next conductor, the gentleman you heard playing that solo, this is really special because the very essence of this group, and actually the very essence of music and the arts in life, period, is lifelong enjoyment, lifelong fulfillment, and finding beauty and joy, peace, serenity, fulfillment through making music and being with others in that act of making music. And that's absolutely what this group represents, because they came running from labs and they came running from all over the city today to be here. The gentleman you heard play the solo is one of the longest standing members of this ensemble, and he doesn't want me to give his age away for sure, but we can say that you've been a member of the group since 2000, right? Since 2000. That's what it's all about. I am very honored and pleased to introduce to you the next conductor of this next piece. We have a new graduate student in the Wind Conducting Studio this year. Her name is Ms. Michelle Stiles. She is from Saskatchewan, but relocated here a few years ago. She teaches at Ecole Sage Creek. She's an elementary music teacher as well as a band director. She is the director of the Winnipeg Youth Wind Ensemble, directs a number of adult brass bands through the summers and guest conducting throughout the year, and just an incredible musician, a very warm, beautiful human, and we're so happy to have her with us this year. Please welcome Michelle Stiles.
Thank you.
The concert band has one last little ditty for you. Many of you might have heard this performed before. This is an arrangement of Percy Grainger's Spoon River, a fiddle tune. And this one is arranged by Robert Sheldon. We hope you've enjoyed this first full performance of this ensemble, and certainly the first fall performance since fall 2019. And prior to that, it was March 2020 when this group performed at its full capacity. So we hope you've enjoyed. Come back and hear more of what's in store for us the rest of the year. And we'll have a very brief intermission, just a stretch kind of thing, while we reset for the wind ensemble and be back in 10 minutes. Thank you. We'll see you back in 10. We have a little shift in our program that came about since the programs were printed. We're going to play the Julie Giroux piece right now entitled One Life Beautiful. This is a very captivating work and a very important work. This composer, Julie Giroux, was commissioned by Ray Kramer, a very well-known, prolific, now retired band director in the U.S., was at Indiana University for many, many years. And his daughter was tragically killed in a car accident, her life taken way, way too soon, had young children. And he commissioned, he and his wife the folks left behind mourning her life, decided to commission this work as not only a celebration of the beautiful person she was and the beautiful life she lived, but the message goes deeper, and the message is that we have one life to live. We've got one chance, and how do we want to do that? And I think the ultimate underlying theme of living with that sense of humility and graciousness and purpose and joy and being the best we can to all people is the underlying message here, that we don't get to do this more than once, and let's do it very well together. This is One Life Beautiful by Julie Giroux.
Thank you.
Okay, well, we have another premiere for you this evening. About a year ago, I was approached by a very, very dear friend and colleague and someone very near and dear to the hearts of the Canadian, Manitoban, and DFOM music community, Dr. Fraser Linklater, who had written a piece and wanted to dedicate it to this ensemble. And this is the world premiere of that piece this evening. For obvious reasons, we couldn't perform it last year, so we have been on this journey with this very exciting and interesting piece in the past 5 weeks. So to tell you a little bit about Dr. Linklater, I am his successor. He was my predecessor. I'm the new DL. He was the director of bands here at the University of Manitoba for 17 years. He studied at the University of Michigan. He studied in Texas as well, and is from Manitoba. And in retirement now has been doing a lot of guest work, clinicking, and doing a lot of writing. So this particular piece is an original composition in 5 movements, and it's an homage to Béla Bartók, the Hungarian composer, who wrote a concerto for orchestra in 1943. The orchestra concerto is much longer, but the 5 movements are kind of parallel. In fact, in title, they're parallel. This evening, we're going to be playing 4 of those 5 movements, and the titles of the movements are parallel to the original. The original is a game of pairs. This is titled Games. And then the 3rd movement is Elegy, the 4th movement, Intermezzo, and the 5th movement, Finale. And like Bartók, that treated the concerto for orchestra literally like every section is a soloist. That's much like the case here. And you'll hear lots of color sonority pairs, a lot of dialogue back and forth between sections. So it kind of is like every section is a soloist. So we really hope you enjoy. We'll acknowledge Dr. Linklater at the end. This is the world premiere of Concerto for Wind Ensemble by Fraser Linklater.
Thank you. Thank you.
Ooh, there's a few notes in that one. Woo! There's a lot of black on those pages. Thank you very much, Dr. Linklater. We've enjoyed the experience, and it's a real honor to be able to create art right at home and allow these students to work with composers, because that's one of the most beautiful interactions is when you can talk to the composer anytime. You know, speed dial, email, text. It's an incredible thing. So we're very grateful that there's so many wonderful composers right here that we frequent with. We are going to close with one more number. Once again, thank you to everyone who assisted with this evening's events, to all the folks here at MBCI for their hospitality and assistance, our DFOM technicians, and of course all of you for being such a wonderful audience and supporting the futures and the music making and all of the journeys of these wonderful people on stage before you. We're going to conclude with a piece by a composer named Yasuhide Ido, a Japanese composer, and this is called Festal Scenes. It's based on four Japanese folk songs, and the inspiration was correspondence with a friend. And the friend wrote, "Everything seems like paradise, blooming all together, and life is a festival indeed." So that is what's being portrayed in this. You'll hear nostalgic folk songs, you'll hear the festival, and featured here we have a taiko drum at the back. You can see it very clearly. So there's several sounds, I guess if you will, that will be directly connected to the culture and the folk songs themselves. So we hope you enjoy. It has been a pleasure performing for you this evening. We'll see you next time. Thank you, everyone. Stay healthy and safe. We look forward to seeing you in December. Bye for now.